I think we have the opportunity as a middle school to push this program really far. I mean, to get kids involved. I mean, we were expecting maybe 8 to 10 to sign up and 22 registered for the program. And I mean, kind of blew our minds, you know, that this is something that kids want. They need, they want to get outside. They want to see the spaces that we have. They want to be out in nature. They want to explore. They want to have fun. They want to see the critters in the water. They want to do all these things. So it's great that we're giving them the opportunity to do that.
Good at lots of things, and he's really talkative and funny. Very funny.
I think he's funny, and into video games.
I know he plays Fortnite a lot, and he's pretty cool.
I've always just been an inside kid, just playing video games, and I'd go outside when my friends want to. But mostly if they have a trampoline, because it's like the only reason I went outside. I'm not the athletic kid, as you can see by, well, yeah.
AJ is a really good friend, and he has learned a lot during adventure and service. He has spent like less time on his phone, and which is good, and I'm really comfortable with him. And he's really good. He's a really good friend.
I think he's really pushed himself. Because I think he's learned a lot, definitely, through this experience. I think it's been really great for him, definitely, to push himself a lot, you know, push his boundaries, you know, especially on the climbing wall and just getting out in the outdoors. And I've been really happy for him, and I've seen him progress a whole lot. Yeah.
I think it's made a huge impact in his life. Just those little tiny things make a huge difference. He keeps trying, he keeps pushing, he keeps moving through those phases, and seeing the phases overcome each day and him growing each day is what's really been special for me. Even today, you know, watching him jump right in there.
It feels cold. It feels cold.
Right in there, kind of problem solving through how to get on the inner tube and then rafting down the stream. I mean, those are big steps for him.
Well, I just swam at the lake after learning some of the basics of canoeing, swimming, and playing a game of monkey in the middle with my friends. I even body slammed Brendan into the water. Probably wasn't the best idea because, well, it was kind of shallow, but
fun is fun,
and life's too short.
What was the hardest part?
There was no hard part. It was just relax and have fun.
One of the best days that I've had so far is when AJ Montoya caught his first fish after about 4 days of battling the lake. That was really, really special, I think, for him. And from what I remember, he was pretty frustrated on the dock. You know, day one, he wouldn't touch a worm. Like, he was adamant he wasn't going to touch a worm.
I'm not touching
it! I would kiss it.
He wasn't going to put it on the hook for certain, let alone touch it. Day two comes and he starts feeling more comfortable. Day three comes, he has his own rod, you know, went out, bought his own fishing rod. Before you know it, he's tying his own lure on, he's casting his own line. And
tell me how many fish you caught today.
I got two.
How many?
Two.
Are you excited?
Yep.
Tell me how you feel about catching two fish.
Well, I feel great because they were both really big fish.
This was your first time ever catching a fish?
Yep.
Are you happy?
I'm very happy.
Show me your happy face.
Those opportunities have just been fantastic to watch for him, because that was really, really special, I think, for him. And since, I think it's made a huge impact in his life.
I'm from Japan. I'm 30 years old.
Tell me some things you've learned during adventure and service.
First time is don't give up. Because if climbing, it is so difficult, but if don't climbing, I can up in 2 times. So if don't give up, sometime we can do it.
Do you know what that word is called in English?
I don't know.
Perseverance.
Perseverance.
Yes, that's right. What have you learned about yourself?
Yourself?
What have you learned about Kotono?
What? How about you in this? This? I should do more sports because almost I hurt my body, hurt my legs, hurt my arms. But I like nature very much, so that is I'm not good sports.
Okay, tell me what you did today.
We do cruising. I don't know the name.
Canoe,
yeah.
Tell me about it.
We have one partner and in the lake we do like more playing, but like we run about survival skill. But also, it's so difficult. I don't have the canoe, so that is so exciting.
Adventure and Service is just a venue for kids who haven't had these experiences of fishing, building outside, like just walking around, just having fun in nature. It's just a venue for them to be able to do that.
Awesome. I guess I've just learned that I really enjoy the outdoors. It's just been just a great time for me to have fun with friends, have fun with nature, and just truly experience more of the facilities and outdoor programs and just areas that Rabun Gap has to offer.
It's just been a lot of fun. We've done fishing with them. I've helped my friends catch fish. I've already had some experience in this area with my family and with other organizations, so I've been able to really assist my friends because I'm definitely one of the more experienced people in the group. And even though it's not a lot of new experiences for me, it's still just been a lot of fun because I've been able to help guide some of the younger people and some of the less experienced people through the challenges.
He might be helping them with their fire.
That's Dominic's way of being.
What do you mean?
He's just always willing to help people, I guess.
Yeah.
He's willing to help people, even if they're not on his team, I'd say.
Today we did canoeing. We learned all about how to deal with capsizing if your canoe capsizes. After we capsized, we had to slide the canoe up on another person's canoe and get all the water out. And it was really difficult, but it was a fun challenge. It's difficult to lift when you have nothing to ground your feet on under the water. So you had to kind of propel it up with your legs. And then you had to get it up there, tilt it, and then bring it back down without getting any more water in it, then flip it back over and get it inside. And you had to do all of that while trying to keep it.
Yay! All right, let's have you guys do it now.
Being out with nature just seems fulfilling. It seems enjoyable. It seems almost like we're humans, we're just meant to be, because I don't know, I just feel more connected with the world around me when I'm outside. And there's an exhilarating feeling with having conquered challenges that nature's put before you.
I think he's really awesome. I mean, he's taught us so many new things. I mean, everything from, you know, how to climb a rock wall to how to, you know, tie a fishing knot. I mean, I learned a lot from him even just over a few months, you know, and I think we all really have, and he set a really great role model for us.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Bysura.
Mr. Bysura is my favorite teacher, because he's the funniest and he's one of the most hardworking teachers that we have at this school. Even though he's like very like on top of things and he works very hard, he also like still likes to have fun and he still likes to be involved with the students.
Go and you can canoe to your heart's content, and I will actually be out there in the future. I'll be on a paddleboarding around with you. And
he's showing us how to canoe, build shelters, identify different plants, and he's just a great person in general.
What are some of your favorite? Hey, y'all keep walking.
Smile.
Keep walking.
No, don't smile. That's a good opportunity. Fix your time.
Got cut.
One, two, three.
Well, I think he's really nice. Mm-hmm. And lots of people say he's a little too bossy at them.
That's not dense enough. all of your bird's nest material needs to be right inside that teepee.
Me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
But I don't think so. I think he's really kind and adventurous.
Mr. Bysura is awesome. We are from different planets because he is so comfortable in this environment, but he has helped me to extend my boundaries and to do things that I have never done. Oh, Lord, help.
And don't go!
Like I said, this is not my comfort zone, but I have enjoyed doing things a little bit out there, and it's been a great time. He's been a great leader. He expects a lot from them, but they love him, and they listen to what he has to say, and they really respect him.
Mr. Bysura is a really nice teacher, and he's a nice leader for the adventure and service group, and we've learned a lot of things from him.
Today's been great, like watching these guys get into the stream, even on when the water's freezing cold. I mean, that's the kind of the thing that I love. You know, they're not afraid to take some risks, but just really experience what it's like to be outside and in this gorgeous place. It's a lot of fun, and it's a lot of work at the same time, you know, because we're not just out here playing every day. We're also doing a lot of service projects. We traveled two or three times to different locations just to, you know, get things done for other people and give back to the people that have made an impact in our life, like the food bank or Pause for Life or the middle school and grounds and maintenance staff that helps us every day. And so if we can give back to them in little ways, it's wonderful for the kids and for us. So I think that's what I want people to take away from it. It's not just that we're out here having fun, but in order to protect it, we also have to understand that we have to be a citizenry that really just recognizes what we have and be thankful for.